Okay, we are continuing with our lessons on insurance. We now know what insurance is. When you talk about insurance, we said that insurance is a contract between two parties, where one of the parties called the insurer for a consideration called premium. In other words, the insurance company, which we refer to as insurer, takes consideration, and we all learned what consideration is in law of contract. So the consideration that the insured pays is called premium. So the insurer takes the premium and then also agrees to indemnify the insured in the event of the occurrence of the risk, which may or may not occur. So we have talked about what insurance is. I remember we said that it is pooling of risk. That means that a lot of people pay small amount, that is the premium, into a pool, and that from the pool, the fortunate help the unfortunate. So it's even said insurance is based on the principle, the fortunate helping the unfortunate. So we have talked about that one. What we are going to look at right now is the terms that are used or you come across when you are learning insurance. So we are looking at terms used in insurance, terms that you come across. So we shall be looking at policy, we shall be looking at proposal, we will look at proposal form, we will look at insured, insurer, premium, actuaries, or the singular actuary. We shall look at adjusters or assessors. We shall look at third party and so on and so forth. So let's start. The first one is the policy. Now when you get up and you say you want to insure something, you want to insure a property, whatever insurance you want to buy, what you are going to buy is the policy, the insurance policy. So you are going to enter, that's why we said insurance is a contract. You are going to enter into a contract with the insurance company. So the policy is the contract where you, the insured, you agree to pay a certain amount called premium. And then the insurer also agrees. Remember, contract is an agreement between two or more parties. So each of the parties has an obligation to fulfill. In this insurance contract, the policy is said that the insured pays premium and then the insurer agrees to indemnify the insured in the event of the occurrence of the risk, which may or may not occur. So the moment the insured pays the first premium, then the policy begins. But insurance is said that just as somebody goes to DVLA for license, if you are through and they need to give you the license, they cannot give you the license the very day you are through. You pass whatever you need to pass. So they will give you something, a temporary document to show that you have the license. So that while they are preparing it, you keep it. And the moment they finish with that license itself, then that one will not work again. In insurance, that is the same thing. When you are through with the policy, after paying your premium, they are supposed to give you the policy, but they cannot give you. They need to go through a certain process. So you'll be given a temporary document to be kept so that whilst they are preparing the policy to be issued or to be given you, if the risk occurs, you can now show that you have insured that particular property or whatever it is. And so you'll be given the cover note. And just it's the same thing that is given to the drivers too when they have not had their license. The cover note will be temporarily given to you so that in the event of the occurrence of the risk, you now present the cover note for. But after some time, when they give you the policy itself, then the cover note will not work. So we are talking about policy.
And you have also mentioned cover note. So you should know what cover note is. So that is the insurance policy. It's the contract itself. The contract itself. And in that contract, you know what you are supposed to do. The insurer also knows what they are supposed to do. Then the proposer. You that are seeking to be insured, you are the proposer. You are the so proposer, to propose, to propose. So you go to the insurance company and then you tell them you want to insure ABCD. You are the proposer. So it's as simple as that. Once you are the you go there and you propose, they will give you the proposer form. And that is one I'm holding from a particular insurance company. This is the QIC, Quality Insurance Company Limited. This is their proposal for. They have several types of the proposal form. So it depends on the policy that you are going for. For example, this one that I have here is a proposal form for motor vehicle insurance. So if you look at it, proposal form for motor vehicle insurance, then into bracket you see private or commercial. So if you are a vehicle owner and you want to insure the vehicle, you go for this one, whether it is commercial vehicle or private one, they will give you this form. And then you fill this form. So you fill this form, everything, some of the things that you see on this form, you have your full name. So they said full name of proposer. So your name will be there. Then your age, address, nationality, house number, email, occupation, mobile number, telephone number, and so on and so forth. Then there are other things that are very important. They said particulars of vehicle. So the vehicle that you want to insure, particulars. So some of the things that you need to give to them are registration number. So what is your car number? You have to indicate it here. Then make and model of the vehicle. So every vehicle has its own the model. So you need to state it here. Type of body. Your vehicle, is it hard body? Is it what body? You have to state it there. Then cubic capacity, you also be stated. They will, if you don't understand, they will guide you to know all those things. The year of manufacturing of that particular vehicle will also be stated. Seating capacity, how many people can you pick? Is it, does it take pick 5, 4? Is it, if it is a taxi, is it 5, 4, or is it what? Everything will be stated there. And so on and so forth. Then other things are engine number, then number. There are several questions they are asking here. For example, question one, is the vehicle private or commercial? So are you going to use it as a private vehicle or commercial vehicle? That one, if it is private, you state. If it's commercial, you have to state it. Then they say A, and at that one, they say A. State the owner in whose name the vehicle is registered. Then the B, is the vehicle subject to a loan? So a lot of information will be there, a lot of information. So when you get the proposal form, you know a lot of this information. This is the front view of it. Then this is the back view of it. So you can walk into any insurance company that you want to see how a proposal form looks like. They will give to you. So that is. So this one is from Quality Insurance Company Limited. So that is for the proposal form. So that is that. So you have the proposal form. Then insured. I've been telling you who the insured is. Now, it's that the proposer. When you are seeking to be insured, you have not been insured. You now go. You are in the process. You are the proposer. That's why they give the proposer form. When you are through, the one that went for the insurance policy is the insured. Then the insurance company is the insurer. Then the insured will pay premium on periodic basis. It can be monthly, it can be yearly. If, for example, you go for third-party insurance policy, which is related to vehicle, every year, normally it's yearly, but if your money, if you cannot pay the yearly one, they can give you 6 months or whatever. But usually, if the period is short, you pay more. In other words, for example, if a year is, let's say, 300 Ghana cedis, you may think that 6 months will be 150. No, 6 months you pay about 200. So it is paid periodically. So if it is monthly, you pay monthly. If it is yearly, you pay it yearly. So that is for the premium. Now, the premium, who calculates the premium? When you go, you see this, the information here will give them clue as to how much you are supposed to pay in the form of premium. So, and there are people who have studied these things. We call them actuaries. So the actuary that is going to assess and estimate, it is going to evaluate the property or the asset or whatever it is, and then determine how much premium you are supposed to pay. That is why you need to tell them the truth, so that they will know exactly how much you are supposed to pay. I have a certain document here, and they were saying something. Let me see. This is from Provident. This is a brochure. I have them here. This one is for a particular policy. This is for marine and aviation insurance policy. This one, Provident, this is for fire and burglary. We shall talk about these things. So fire policy, burglary policy. And I was telling you something. If you lie to them, there is something here. One of the things they have here, they say conditions. And I'm going to read something. They said, one, if there is any material misdescription of any property hereby insured, or of any building or place in which such property is contained, or any misrepresentation as to any fact material to be known for estimating the risk, or any omission to state such facts, the insurer shall not be liable upon this policy so far as it relates to property affected by such misdescription, misrepresentation, or omission. So when you are filling the form, all that is to say that when you are filling the form, tell them the truth. If you lied, so you know you have done misrepresentation in law of contract. And when you say description, so you say misdescription, you need to describe certain things to them. For example, if it is a filling station, it's at a certain place. Describe the nature of the place to them. They know that you are close to a fire where the filling station can easily catch fire, whatever. All those things will determine how much premium you are supposed to pay. So if you don't do that, and then anything happens, if you lie, they say they will not be liable. In other words, the contract may be void, and you may not be compensated. So take note of that, and it's the actuary who will look at all those things and determine how much you are supposed to pay. So the premium you pay, they determine it. And maybe some of you can even, those of you, if you are doing elective maths, as a business student, you can decide to do that course in university. If you go to University of Cape Coast, they have a course they call, or a program they call actuarial science. These are the people who are trained. In fact, but you must be very good at mathematics. And that's why if those who did elective maths, they are those who will be allowed to do that, the actuarial science. So if you charter and you do, if you study harder and then you charter, you can become an actuary. and actually, and then you'll be doing some of these things. Then adjusters or assessors, very simple. Now you see, when you were seeking to be insured as a proposer, is the actuaries or the actuary that determine the premium. Now the risk has occurred. So who is supposed to evaluate and examine the extent to which the risk had occurred, so that they will also determine how much to be paid to you, your claims, how much to be paid to you. That one will be done by the adjusters. So the adjusters are employed by insurance companies to examine and evaluate claims. If the risk had occurred, you will go for claim form. So it's the adjusters who examine the extent of the risk and determine how much to be paid to you. So you see the difference between adjusters and then actuaries. This one's determine the premium to be paid. This one will determine the how much is supposed to be paid to you. So that is for that one. Then another thing that you come across is third party insurance. If your father has a car, if your father has a motor, and your father has decided to do the right thing, you will go for third party insurance policy. It's compulsory for all road motor vehicle owners. It's compulsory. So if a policeman meets you and the policeman says your insurance, he's talking about the third party. Other ones are not compulsory. There's one we call comprehensive that covers the car itself. So that if the car is involved in accident, the insurance company will compensate you. But for the third party, the vehicle is not included. It is only the third party. And we have learned about who a third party is in under law of contract. And the third party is the one who is not a party to the contract. The insurance contract is between if it is a vehicle, it's between the owner of the vehicle. If it's any property, the owner of the property, and then the insurance company. So now we are looking at third party insurance. It is related to motor vehicles or cars or whatever. So you go for third party insurance. In the event of the occurrence of an accident, the insurance company will compensate the third parties. And who are the third parties? For commercial vehicles, the passengers will be the third party. So the insurance company, if you have bought it and you paid your premium, then the compensation will go to them. Remember, we have learned about privity of contract, where we said if you are not a party to a contract, you cannot enforce it. But we learned about exceptions, and you remember we said third party insurance is an exception. What we learned there was that even though the third party was not a party to the contract, he can enforce it. So they themselves can claim the money from the insurance company. So that is for third party insurance.